Well, most of you probably don't know, but Michael met Alicia at his 15th birthday party, and I don't know if Alicia wants me to share this story, but I'm gonna anyways.
Yeah, share
it. Me and Alicia met through church.
I started going to youth group with my cousin, so, you know, I just saw this kid, you know, 15, 16-year-old kid, and we're just like, look, I just saw him, you know, and I don't know, I just thought he was cute, I guess, you know, so.
I thought she was cute. She came to church first. She was coming in her softball uniform. She would come from school.
After my mom had told him to invite her because she was new to youth group. And after Michael didn't talk to her all day, just because he didn't really know her, they sat down at the fire and started talking, and Michael, being the obedient son that he is, didn't give her his phone number, but asked for her email. After she asked him if they could just exchange numbers, he said yes, and that whole obedient son act went right out the window. Because that's just how much he liked her.
From the beginning, Michael has been in love with Alicia. I would watch him always be looking over at Alicia and talking to her and wanting to protect her when Stevie, our youth pastor at the time, would make us play the ball game. I've been so fortunate to watch them grow up together and to have found each other at such a young age. I know it's a story of patience and honoring the Lord, and he has been so faithful to them, and all of you are witnesses to that today.
So we were like best friends for a solid year or so, but once I got to know her and just the person that she was, you know, fell in love with her, yeah.
Honestly, the first year of being best friends and the first year of dating, I really fell in love with him. And ever since we were young, we're like, I want to get married. Like, this is like we're meant to be. The Lord just put us together, and you know, we balance each other out so perfectly. And it's really just a true love story, honestly.
So our first day, surprisingly, was actually our 1 year anniversary.
We've never been on a date because we were so young. We couldn't drive.
Up until then, we just hung out, you know, whether it would be kind of here at my house or at her house or at church. But then when we finally like went out to like dinner for the first time, we went to Yanni's where her mom works.
My mom had the table all set up, cute little kisses on the tables, and we got kitty cocktails, both of us, and I still have the picture in my phone today, and it's just crazy how time flies.
Alicia and I, a couple years ago, about 4 or 5, we're laying down at midnight in the bed on the retreat, and it was around the first time she met Michael, and she said she just wanted to marry him right away. And I can't believe 6 years later it's here and that you two stayed so faithful and patient.
So we got engaged about 2 years ago. It was May 16th, 2017.
And he did it at Hamlin Beach Park, you know, and so he took me out on a picnic date.
She had no clue what was going on, and so, you know, played it off pretty good.
Kind of, he's like, close your eyes. So I closed my eyes, I'm looking down. He was in front of me. I see his feet move behind me. So I kind of knew at that moment, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna get engaged right now. So he's like, open your eyes and turn around. So I turned around, he's on his knee. He's like, will you marry me, Alicia Sotomayor? And I was like, is this real right now? I was like, is this really happening right now?
At first she was a little confused as to what was going on. So I repeated the question again. You know, like, okay, so like, you know, you wanna do this or what? And so she finally, you know, she said yes, and you know, in shock. And then we went back to, you know, her family's house. And
all my family friends were at the house. We go there, and I'm just like out of it. I didn't even eat dinner. I'm just like, whatever, you know, so. But yeah, that was the best time.
Guys, I'm honored to be your best man and to share this special day with you. And to be honest, when you guys first got engaged, I'm thinking like, wow, 2 years, that's a long time. I don't really think I ever thought about what I would do when this day finally came. But now that it's here, it seems like it flew by so fast, and I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
Talking in the back before we came out, and Michael was saying how today's their anniversary. And I said, well, not yet. We gotta make sure Alicia's dress is really needing fixing and she's not really leaving the church, everything's okay. And no, he said, no, we started dating 6 years ago. So I said, well, geez, what does that put you to, like 14, 15 years old? And he said, yeah, and it's, you know, same for Alicia, just a year behind him. And I was thinking, man, how amazing, again, just another thing that they've been exemplary in, and just only being with each other, that they've never really even dated anyone else besides each other.
You know, I'm really excited for today, and you know, that I love her, and I'm so excited to spend the rest of my life with her, and always and forever, like we've been saying from the beginning.
I just hope that you're not nervous. I don't know if you'll cry or not, but I'm ready to be married after 6 years of waiting, you know, since we were kids. And on our 6 year anniversary, it's a special time, so I pray that your nerves aren't, you know, happening right now, and I love you and I can't wait to be your wife.
I'm so grateful to be gaining a sister like you. I'm so excited for you guys in this next season of life. You're such lights and godly examples to everyone who knows you.
Thank you for being two of my best friends and allowing me to be alongside you on your special and big day. And you two are my favorite people in the world, and I love you both dearly.
I promise, by the grace of God and the power of the Holy Spirit, to be faithful and to love you as Jesus loves the church.
I promise, by the grace of God and the power of the Holy Spirit, to be a faithful wife and to love you with agape love.
I now pronounce you husband and wife. Michael, you may kiss your bride. Yeah.